What's up, guys? It's Coop Dizzle here, and welcome back to another episode on the Diamond Society SMP. It is another beautiful day here in Red Star, hanging out in the slums, and we have a really, really cool episode planned for you guys today. I want to apologize first off for my morning voice. I just woke up, and second of all, if I'm a little bit down this episode, there's a really good reason for that, and I'll get to that more when we do the personal update part of the episode. But we have some really big projects to do. First of all, well, we'll talk about the first one here in a second, but check this out. Three Ravens came over here. He said, "Thanks for all the help, man. P.S. If you need any more, feel free to raid my storage barn." So basically, I've helped out Traven in a few times, clearing out a bunch of mountains and stuff. You can see the wall now is starting to go in place, the wall that's going to protect us from any future zombie apocalypse. At least it'll protect the people inside the wall. It won't protect us out here in the slums. But yeah, so since I helped him out with that, he came over and check this out, man. He dropped off double chest upon double chest. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 double chests worth of blocks. Mostly stained clay and smooth stone. But check it out. Who knows what we can build with all this stuff, man. So Traven, thank you so much. Oh, and speaking of thank yous, I have to say, guys, thank you so, so much for all of your support on the Diamond Society Season 2. It has been unbelievable. So have some diamonds on me. But guys, to give you an idea, I tell you what, the first episode, I want to say it's up to over 120 views, which is incredible. And then both of the episodes, 1 and 2, episode 2 is at like 150, are you kidding me? And then both of them have something like 32 or 35 likes and almost 50 comments per video. I mean, guys, you are unbelievable. So please, have some more diamonds on me. You guys deserve it. And if you do enjoy this video, please, please, please make sure that you hit the like button and share it with your friends, okay? So make sure I get all my diamonds back. I'm pretty sure I had 64 diamonds. I'm just saying, where did the other 4 go? Well, we did some mining last episode, so we're not like... Or actually, we haven't yet. That is pre-recorded stuff. But yeah, so anyway, I guess we're not that poor. Oh, here they are. Whew, I was about to just leave those on the ground. So first things first, guys, last episode we built this clock tower over here, and you really liked how it turned out, which is awesome. Let me know if you want to see a let's build of this clock tower, then please tell me, because I'd be happy to do it. And in fact, speaking of let's builds, I have a let's build on this house that's going to start up on Thursday, so please keep your eye out for that if you're interested. But everybody, except for one person, I think, we pretty much all agreed in the comments that we want the bell tower on top of this. So, that's going to be our first project. But before we do that, I thought that I would take you guys on a little tour. You can see that there's been a lot of development here in the slums, and you can maybe even notice some new retainer walls. So, actually, I'm going to go out of order if I do that. So I'll tell you what, let's do this first. Let's build the clock tower, or the bell tower, on top of the clock tower. And then we'll come back and see how that looks. All right, well, there she is. What do we think? It looks a little bit different than I remember. Now, I didn't go back and check my design on the creative world. I just kind of free-handed it, you know what I mean? It's a pretty simple design. I figured I could get it right. I think it looks pretty cool. From a distance, it maybe looks a little bit strange. I'll tell you what, let's just hop down here, and we will swim through the canals here that we made in the last episode. And let's see, we go up the steps here. Up close, however, I think it looks really cool. I really, really like how it looks when you're just, you know, on street level and looking up at it, right? So, now there's a lot of stuff I haven't shown you guys. I haven't really shown you the interior yet. I don't think it was done in the last episode. So, oh man, yeah, that clock even works too. I didn't think about that. In the creative world, it doesn't work properly. Like, it just sits there. That's really cool. Anyway, let's go in here, and this is the map now. And so I think, I don't know, we may have shown this in the last episode when we did the clock tower, but I'm not sure. So people are welcome to come in and update their map and whatnot. But I actually tried to do a little bit of detail work on the inside. Now there's not much, but you climb up here and then you have this ladder that goes all the way up. Now a lot of these places, like right here, there's really nothing. Here I just put a bunch of bushes. And here, there's really not a whole lot, but I put a little step up to the windows so you can kind of peek out, I guess. And then continuing up now, this room is where the clock faces are, so I tried to squeeze in some really tiny gears here on all of the clock faces, which I think turned out pretty cool. And then finally we get up to the bell tower here. Now you gotta watch your step because there's really not much room. I went ahead and left this open. That's different from the last episode. This was just a roof. Now that we have the bell here, we need a chamber for the bell to resonate in. So that's what this is. We've got the rope that's holding the bell up, and then we come out here. And yeah, it's pretty cool. We've got a really nice view. Of course, you can walk around, and you've got views everywhere. What is this? I thought I saw synchronize. It's not a Minecraft thing. Has anyone ever seen that? Okay, fine. All right, press the Y button. Weird. Hey, it's really pretty. That's really cool. I guess that is that something they added in the update? Oh, leap of faith. What's all this? Yeah, I guess we'll do that too. All right, let's see. Let's see what happens. Leap of faith. Let's go. Oh, okay. That's pretty cool. Yeah, so we've got some Assassin's Creed action going on now, thanks to the clock tower. And speaking of, this clock tower, I haven't really talked about it much, but this clock tower is going to have something special about it. And, do we want to get into that this episode? I think so. I'm going to do a little bit more work. I'm going to do a little bit of surprise work on the clock tower, and then I'll be right back. I'll show you what we've got going, and we'll talk a little bit more about what this clock tower is going to mean. Okay, guys, check this out. So, here's the thing. Last season, let me go ahead. Oh, well, I can't de-armor. I still got all my stuff on me. Last season, you know, I wish that we would have had sort of like a group watching President Annis and really keeping a closer eye on him. And so, you know, like I said, everyone's doing what they can. I think I talked about this in the last episode. Everyone's doing what they can to prevent what happened last season from happening again this season. So you can see three ravens, or Traven, sorry, now is building up this massive wall. It's going to be 40 blocks tall, and it goes all the way around the walled city. I mean, this is a humongous project, and he's been just gradually tinkering away, adding one layer at a time. For me, I feel like that's good, but I feel like we need to keep an eye on the people in power, right? So we need to have sort of an underground network of people who are keeping a watchful eye over the people who are making decisions. And so I think what we should do is start a group, but it has to be a secret group, so you can't tell anybody. But it's got to be a secret group, because if people know that we're watching them, well, it's not going to work, right? So we've got the clock tower. The clock tower is, I mean, there are clock towers all over the place. There are going to be one day clock towers all over the place. So there's nothing out of the ordinary about this. But if you were to throw an item over here, then you get a secret entrance. Oh yeah. Thank you, Hodag. Hodag and his friend Rick for working out this for me. I originally put in my own, but the problem with the design that I had, I just followed a tutorial. Actually, it wasn't my own design or anything. And of course, lag is an issue. Let's see if we can get this, because you can go back up. Yeah, there we go. So the problem, there we go. Okay, the problem with the design that I had originally used was that it used buttons. So I had a button here, and then just to kind of hopefully throw people off, I put one here, here, and here to make it look like a design. But that's pretty obvious. Like, if you come in, you just walk into a room and be like, ooh, buttons, and you're gonna start clicking the buttons, right? You know, it's that childish part. So I thought we need to do something that doesn't use buttons. And so I contacted my redstone friend, Howitzer, and he talked to one of his friends, and they worked this out together where it uses an item to activate the trapdoor instead. So that's really cool. Let's go around here, and this is where you pick your items back up. So it's all good. And then I went ahead and started digging out an underground base for this secret society. And so the secret society, guys, it's going to be called the Cronus Knights. Cronus, I think, is like a god of time or something like that. And since we're going to be located in a clock tower, I thought that would be really cool. So, and the whole purpose of this group is going to be to keep a watchful eye over the new Red Star City and make sure that the people who are interested in running things, that they're not doing anything nefarious, okay? And if they are nefarious, we're going to put a stop to it. But yeah, this is all I've got so far. It looks like Howitzer, after he got done with this door design, he came through and added some stone brick stairs and stuff. So I don't know, we're gonna come back and redesign this later, but this is gonna be the underground HQ for the Cronus Knights. And so we are the first members. We're going to be the founders, and then we've got to bring in some other people to kind of help us out too. But yeah, one of these corridors is going to lead to a meeting chamber, and then the other corridor is going to lead to a ritual chamber. So we've got to build the ritual chamber before we can initiate anybody. So that'll probably be a project that we start working on in the next episode, maybe. Is my internet that bad? No, it shouldn't be. I mean, it's a little bit bad. It shouldn't be that bad. I hate this stuff. So anyway, guys, what we've got to do next is... or it's actually something I already did off camera. I had to record this episode way out of order. But we basically... Addictive G is moving into the slums, and she's moving into a part without retainer walls. And so she asked us, she said, hey, would you build some of your walls over on this island? Because I really love those walls, and I'd really like to have those. And I said, yeah, absolutely, you know. So we got to work, and I recorded a time lapse for you. So you know what that means? It is...
epic build time.
Oh, yeah. Let's get to work.
This is great. Rain, rain, rain. Not even the ducks wouldn't come out in weather like this. But me, I'm an idiot.
I hope you guys enjoyed that time lapse. If you did, make sure that you give the video a thumbs up, please. And man, it looks good. I think that the new wall looks good over here on Addictive G's Island. Of course, it's the same design that we did last episode. But there's another wall design too. Because see, Oh, by the way, I'm sorry, I want to apologize a little bit about that time lapse, guys. I actually had some more angles, and I tried to do the best I could with what I had, but I lost a lot of that footage because I'm actually recording with OBS now. I've always used DxTory, I'm switching to OBS, and yeah, let's just say there's a learning curve, and I lost some footage because of that learning curve. But anyway, so this is one block shorter than the other walls that we've done. I think it still turned out really, really nice, and it's really fun to walk on too. But in between episodes as well, because I wasn't able to record a whole lot recently. Again, we'll talk about that here in just a second. But this wall here is sort of like a mishmash of the wall design we did around the commercial area, the downtown area of the slums, so to speak, and this wall design over here. So it's the same thing, except I just switched it out with a stone brick palette. And man, I really like how that looks. I mean, it's so detailed. It has so much character. But yeah, guys, hey, let me know, by the way, sorry I'm kind of switching gears a lot here, but let me know if the video looks any better or worse with the OBS thing. Hopefully it looks a little bit better. I'm kind of enjoying it more, to be honest, once I get everything set up right. But yeah, so I did a wall over, okay, over here, that's Traven's little area that he's building up there. And then over here as well, no one's really building in this area, but yeah, we've got it. So the only island that's left now is this island over here, right there. And yeah, by the way, check that out. Is that sick or what? It's got, well, it's a little bit hard to see from here. I think that's Hodag's build right there. It's got like legs and stuff. It's really, really cool. Anyway, the slums are really cool in general, man. There was some other stuff too that I wanted to show you guys. Am I going the right way here? I don't think I am. I think the easy way is gonna be to go this way. But yeah, I did some other work too that was sort of off camera. Made a couple of bridges that I want to show you guys. So we're going to zip on over this way. Here's all the work we did in the last episode. But I did two bridges that you didn't get to see that I wanted to kind of just show, just so everyone knows, like, if you see it in other people's videos, you know where the bridges came from. I wish that I could have recorded it, and I just wasn't really able to. So here's the first bridge right here. I think this one turned out okay. It's a little bit too clean, but otherwise I think it's fine. It's kind of cool. I like how this sort of wraps around the log right here. The underneath side of it is weird though, and that's because these two retainer walls both ran at angles like this, and usually you want the land to go like straight across, and you put the bridges where the land is going straight across. Like this one turned out much better because of that, but this one, the underneath side is a little bit weird. It's got sort of this tunnel effect to it, and yeah, I broke a couple of lily pads earlier. Man, it's so tough to get around, but you know, these lily pads, they add a lot, so I'm gonna keep adding them. But anyway, yeah, so this bridge, I'm really, really proud of. Let's get a good view of this one real quick. I think you guys are going to dig this one. So anyway, I'm not really great at bridges, but this one works, and I think the reason it works, and I think it works really well, I've got some compliments on it, and I think that's because there's so much depth. So we've got this cobblestone arch here, and then if we can back up a little bit, we've got these stone brick arches. And then I thought, you know, I need to break that up. I need some more design. So I added the logs to it too as a third layer of arch. And so, well, it's like, what do I put in the middle here? I tried just the spruce fence, but that by itself didn't really break it up a whole lot. So what really makes it pop is that black stained clay behind the oak fence. I think it makes it really, really cool. But anyway, so we've just about got all the infrastructure in the slums completed, and that's exciting. We've got one more island to put a wall around. Oh, another lily pad, I think. Where are you, the lily pad? I don't see it. Huh. Okay. So we've got one more retainer wall to do. We've got a lot of road work to do. I'm kind of sad about that. And we've got at least one bridge to build. But after that, man, everything is going to be very well established for the slums. And that's exciting because that means we're going to be able to focus on other things, which we're going to focus on some other things anyway. So speaking of which, one of the big things that I didn't really mention that I meant to at the beginning of the episode, when I was talking about all those chests, you remember that? How like we have all those chests. Well, I totally meant for us to be in this house for several episodes. You know, that's why I put so much effort into it. But we're just outgrowing that storage room. Like everything, all the chests are full and I've got just stuff coming out of my ears. So we need a bigger storage area, and that means it's time to start our base project. Oh baby. So I tell you what, I'm going to head over to the location for our base for the season, and I'll see you over there. Oh my gosh, take it in, guys. That is BC's steampunk Big Ben. And ah, it's gorgeous, isn't it? Check it out. That's the pendulum on the inside. You've got little counterweights and strings holding it up. He's almost done. He's working on the very top, and there's the clock face with the diamond blocks. And he's got little sprinkles of diamond block in the door, I think he calls it, the door of the grandfather clock. What's up, BC? And so, man, that is just so impressive. Don't worry, I've got our first skyscraper. The design's almost done, my friends. Here in an episode or two, we're going to get ours done too. But yeah, let me get over to where our base is going to be. See, you guys have only, if you've only been watching my videos, you've only seen what's going on in the slums, but actually, there are five different areas to Red Star. So over there, we can see a little bit of stuff is happening over in the Docklands area. That's coming along really nicely. Lurgan's got these really sick looking crane legs, but that's going to be a giant crane that's holding up his massive mob farm. Oh, I just fell in with the sheep over here. But yeah, you can see the mob farm over there. So he's going to build like a giant crane that's sort of hoisting that up. Just really, really cool ideas. Lots of cool stuff going on in Factorium. And of course, we've got the beautiful clock tower. We've got another skyscraper coming up there. We have a building there. We have some sort of like giant machine thingy. I don't know what it's going to be, but it looks really cool over there. So guys, things are coming along all over the server. Again, Traven is just this massive wall project. I mean, things are really, really rocking and rolling on the Diamond Society. Anyway, did I just date myself by saying rocking and rolling? This is, moving on, this is the area for the new base. And, my friends, it's going to be an airship base. Oh yeah, an airship base. That's going to be a lot of fun, I think. And so I picked this spot here because I know that this is about where the wall is. And I want it to look like it's sort of flying over the wall and into the walled city. And that's also going to give us a really cool view of Factorium, a really cool view of the Docklands, and at least a cool view of this quadrant of the walled city. So we're going to have really cool, sort of a really cool perspective of everything that's going on right now. And by the way, lots of people on the server tonight. That's really, really cool. So that's the plan, guys. And I have been grinding away off camera. So you can see I've got a little over half a double chest of wool here, a full double chest of wool here. And with this sheep farm in place, I mean, we can get like 6 or 7 or 8 stacks of wool at a time if we need to. What else have we got in here? Right, spruce wood's going to be a big component. We're going to use a little bit of dark wood too. Originally, I thought I was going to use a bunch of nether brick, but I decided to go against that one. And to be honest, I'm not 100% sure. I don't have 100% of the design for the base down aesthetically, but I do have the concept down, and I know how big the balloon's going to be. So that's what we're going to build today, is the balloon. If we do get any more of the balloon done or any more of the airship done, that would be cool, but I'm not going to really push myself to do it because I want to make sure this episode gets out to you guys. You already missed a week last week. So anyway, you know what that means, right? We're doing another one. It is
epic build time.
Oh yeah, let's do it.
All I do is win. All I do is win. All I do is win. All I do is win.
Oh man, I'm so happy with how this turned out, you guys. Check it out. Here's what it looks like from the ground level. I think she's looking pretty BA, so really cool. And that's my rapper-inspired steampunk airship balloon. We got her name on a blimp. Officially, guys, I've been wanting to do that for so long, you have no idea. Now, we still have some details tied to it. There were some things I couldn't show in the time-lapse because they involved experimentation, like the front part and the fin. Some experimenting that you didn't even see because it failed, you know? But we're gonna try and add some more details to this later, and we're also, we have to add either a cabin down here, or we have to add a actual ship sort of thing, which is what I'm going for just for space purposes. But anyway, guys, I was already 40 seconds over my allotted time for this episode. So if you enjoyed it, please make sure and hit the like button for me. Feel free to share this with your friends and spread a good word about the channel and the series. Also, subscribe if you're new, join the Coop Dizzle family, and continue to follow along as we ball hard here on the Diamond Society SMP. Oh, hang out with me in the comments, please. Let me know what you thought of the episode, and also whether or not this looks better with OBS. That would be much appreciated. And until next time, my friends, may you be happy, may you be well, and take care. I'll see you later.